Now, based on the superposition principle, we need to understand stationary waves, of course, application of it. Before going to discuss about stationary waves, so let us go through the reflection of transverse waves and transmission of transverse waves. These two topics to be discussed. Reflection at one end, which is maybe fixed or free. Similarly, transmission from one medium to another medium, if this wave transmits, then how it will be transferred. That means what will be the changes in it. Here in this case, reflection case, if you consider that it is one end, it is fixed. Now a pulse has been created and it is traveling in the string with a velocity v. So here, and reaching to this particular end of it, here, simply. This is rigidly fixed, if you consider. Then here in this case, when this particular wave disturbance is traveling, this point P is ready to move. It is not displaced. So the next neighboring particle is applying force on it so that it will be displaced along that. So here, this one is, and this one, the tension T in it, if you take this one as this one, like this. So this one is trying to pull it up, this one is trying to oppose it. So here the same thing happens, but here in this case, this point is attached with this rigid support so that there will be no displacement in this. Instead of that, this one is pulled down. As a result, just falls on it, the same thing. And this one will be pulled down with equal and opposite force based on Newton's third law. So here in this case, this point will move down like this. So it becomes horizontal at that one instant, like this. It's coming back to original position. And then simply it will be turned like this. So completely the crust incidence on it will be turned like this, like trough. So here in this case, now this is moving with velocity v in opposite sense. And so here, if you take y is equals to a times of sine kx minus omega t, if you consider, this one will become y is equals to a sine of kx plus omega t. Now question arises, sir, in this case, will there be any loss in energy or not? Yes. And hence, this value is said to be amplitude of reflected wave. This is amplitude of incident wave. How to get these values? Of course, we will discuss in due course. But now, this is completely inverted. So you can say here, compared to crust becomes trough-like in the sense. A phase difference is introduced between the incident one and the reflected one. A phase difference is introduced. That phase difference value is equals to pi it is. So phase difference pi introduced means here this amplitude is modified, sine of kx plus values because of this velocity direction is changed. And in addition to that, if you add this pi, then this value of it is sine of pi plus theta, it is equals to minus er sine of kx plus omega t will be the case. So here, this is how the reflection takes place. Similarly, this can be understood and it is in fixed region. In some cases, we can just understand this one. If it is a rigid surface, like if a wave is approaching towards it, pulse is approaching towards it, like this. This wave pulse may be of any shape, harmonic in the sense we are taking this one like this. Or if you consider some another wave pulse like this, means wave pulse like this. So here square wave pulse. So to understand this reflection phenomenon in a simplest way, so take extension of this one, either is rigid boundary or a fixed one in this sense, take it like that it is coming in opposite sense with the same velocity at the same distance. When it comes to this edge of it, this one will be the situation the next instant. So as it is trying to cross this, this one tries to cross it. So this one becomes real and this one becomes virtual is the one way of giving explanation for reflection of the wave. So that superposition of these two waves will result exactly what is happening at this particular point of reflection. So this one will be like this. This is the case. Half of it means, so this will be the case for half of it. So this becomes virtual and this becomes real. Superposition of these two will result exactly this situation when it falls on it. Next instant, suppose if you extend the same, in the next instant you can say this one becomes real like this, whereas this one becomes virtual like this. Superposition of these two will yield a kind of thing that this is maximum than this. So this will be the superposition of it. So this will be the resultant wave. So gradually it grows such a way, this becomes virtual and this becomes real, which is represented here in this picture. So like this, superposition of the two waves can be used. Okay, one is real and another one is virtual, provided it is rigid boundary. In the sense, there will be inversion of it simply, and which is moving in opposite sense like this. So superposition of these two will give this exact reflection phenomena. So it is easy to understand by using superposition of such a type of real and virtual waves. So now if you consider the similar way, if you consider another type of wave, that means pulse like structure, that means what we are trying to introduce here simply, this is the pulse like. So here on the other side of it, we need to assume same type of pulse but moving in opposite sense. So by taking the similar scenario, we can explain what is going to happen at the rigid boundary of it. So this is reflection phenomena. So here our next criteria is to discuss about AI and ER. Before that, here it is the rigid boundary like surface, so this point is fixed, that is what we consider. Now if we change it, no, it is not rigidly bounded end of it. So let us consider that the string has, okay, a ring like structure here which can be vibrated freely up and down if it is free enough. Then here in this case, will it be the same scenario just like what we considered? Means it's not. So here in this case, simply what will happen is when this wave is transmitted and reaches to this particular edge of it, this particular particle which is neighboring to it is applying force on this ring in upward sense. That means here, as it is just moving like this, so this is the point. You may assume that this is the wave is trying to lift that ring. But the point is here, what about half of the wave is reached, means what about the remaining half of the wave energy, where it is going? So usually if this amplitude is A, when it is superimposed here like this on this particular thing, this ring will be raised up to certain instant that it becomes 2A like this. So to understand this, one thing is energy is not being wasted. Even a part of it is energy wasted, means remaining part of energy is trying to pull it up. So here, ideal condition I am taking, no energy is being wasted, so it is totally, it is raised up to 2A like that. So how we can explain this one, means here in this case, so this is the free boundary, this is the pulse like this, means you need to consider the pulse in the same sense but moving in opposite directions like this. So here what happens is, at this ring, when it falls on this ring, this one also falls. This is the virtual thing if you consider. So here when this one falls on it like this, this is the ring, this is the part of it. So this is the second ring, second wave, which is the part of it. So superposition of this displacement, this one, A plus A, it becomes resultant displacement of it, maximum displacement, it will become 2A. So the ring rises up to 2A due to superposition of two waves here. So that's why it becomes 2A. In the next instant, the one will be like this, the second one will be like this. So again superposition of these two, that means this displacement, this is being added. So finally, it will become like this. So finally what will happen is, this one is turned like this and it is just propagating with same velocity in opposite sense. But here crest incidence on it means again it will be crushed like this. So in this case, the phase difference introduced will be equals to zero. In the same way, it will be bounced back. So here in this case, if you take this one as incident wave equation, for this you can write, for this we can write y is equals to a reflected times sine of kx plus omega t, and there is no phase difference introduced. So simply it becomes a sine of kx plus omega t. So this is reflected wave in the case of a fixed end and the mobile end, like that is a ring like structure, so that it can be displaced up and down. So here in this case, in the same string whatever we consider, the wave is moving back in the same string, that in opposite sense. So instead of such a type of thing, if you take a transmission of a wave, that means one medium to another medium, that means one string to another string, if it is transmitted, then what is going to happen? So it's not about this end like structure, this is another string will begin here. So one string to another string, if it is moving, then what will be the transmission case? Next, in the case of transmission, that means this is one string, like this is another string, like if it is considered, that means two strings under same tension, tension T is same, whereas this mu value is mu 1, this mu value is mu 2, where mu stands for mass per unit length, or you can say linear density. One is thin string, another one is a thick string, thin and thick. If it is the case, if mu value is different, means, you know, velocity of the transverse wave as we got, same tension means T root over T by mu it is. Means here mu value is changing, means V value is going to change. Velocity of transverse wave passing through that string is changing. As mu 1 is less than mu 2 if you take, if it is taken, then V 1 value will be greater than V 2. V 1 value will be greater than V 2. Under the same tension, in thin string velocity is more than the thick string when the transverse wave is propagating through it. So here in this case, in analogy with optics or something like that, where you will come across the refractive index of it, and hence you will see it is optically a denser medium. If refractive index is more, then you will say it is optically a denser medium. If refractive index is less, then optically it is rarer medium. So there you will come across optical density, if you come across. So you will come across optical density, and if it is more, velocity is of light in that is less. Similarly, optical density is less, velocity of light in that is more. So it is not at all concerned with the actual density of the material. It is purely about optical density of it. That means how it is allowing the light waves to pass through it. That is the nature of it. Nature of the material, it depends. So similarly here, optical density, like in comparison with, you can say it is acoustical density, like it is. In this case, velocity is more, optical density is less. Velocity is more means optical density is less. Similarly, velocity is more in the sense acoustical density is less, like. That means here V1 is greater than V2. That means in thin string, velocity is more in the sense acoustical density, like it is less, you can take. Velocity is more means acoustical density is less, like you can assume. So acoustical density is less in the sense this is a rarer medium, like an acoustic wave you can talk about. So here, sir, acoustical in the sense only we may come across sound only. Yes, longitudinal waves only it is, usually it has been used. And here in this case also, a similar way, that effective density, like if you use a similar term of it, not the density of the material. So linear density is different from that term like this. Okay, if you compare it, it will be different. My intention is to say here, any transverse wave is propagating through this one like this, means if mu value is less than this, velocity is more in that. So now it is propagating like this. Then what will happen if this is incident on it? So here velocity is more, velocity is less here in this case. At this end, if it is just trying to pass through it, what will happen is here less velocity in the sense definitely there will be kind of reflection like this, and at the same time there will be transmission of wave like this. a part of energy will be reflected and a part of energy will be transmitted. So the reflected wave, that energy means it is also in the form of wave only. This wave, okay, will be out of phase with this one at this particular junction, at this junction, okay. So because this one is just behaving like a rigid end like, partially rigid end like, so that there will be a phase difference. Suppose from thick string to thin string, if the wave is getting transmitted, that means here in this case, this is mu 2, highly denser one to rarer one like, if you consider. So here in this case, if you come across this, then what will happen is there is a transmitted one and there is a reflected one like this. In the case of reflected one, okay, it will be in phase with this. There will be no any phase change. So here in this case, okay, this is how the energy will be splitted as a transmitted energy like, and this amplitude is a reflected one. This is reflected amplitude, this is transmitting amplitude, this is the incident amplitude like. So this is how the transmission takes place briefly. So now the point is, okay, how to arrive a conclusion to find this transmitted amplitude, reflected amplitude and all these things. So here at this boundary, exactly at this boundary, what exactly happens, that what we need to discuss. So my point of it is, at this particular incident, so this is the second one. So wave has been just imposed on this, is trying to influence this at this boundary, simply at the boundary of it simply. So here there is a transmitted wave at this boundary. This is a part of it, this junction is a part of this transmitted wave as well as a reflected. So here the left part of the string, we got the two continuously coming wave, incident one, and continuously reflecting wave part of it. So on the left side part of it, we got two waves here simply. So that means here at this one, incident one plus reflected one are getting superimposed on the left hand side part, whereas on the right hand side it is only transmitted wave. So here this particular junction, whatever it is, simply modified like this, means this displacement is same in the perspective of this thick string, in the perspective of this thin string. So in the perspective of thin string, it is a superposition of incident and reflected one. In the perspective of thick string, it is purely transmitted wave. So this displacement is same. One point cannot have two different types of displacements, okay, from this main position. No, it is not possible. That's why sum of these two will be equals to yt of it. This is one equation. And similarly, the other one, this junction, if you consider, junction is considered. So that this is the string, you can take this is the point. So at this particular point, this is nothing but the resultant of yi plus yr. So here the slope of this tangent, if you consider, and in this direction also slope of the tangent, if you consider, okay, these values, suppose if you take it as origin, x is equals to 0, the slope of this tangent, that means dyi by dx plus dyr by dx should be equals to dy transmitted 1 by dx. The slope of that one will be same as this. So these two conditions are said to be boundary conditions. Boundary conditions, that means at the junction when the wave is getting transmitted. It may be from thin to thick or thick string to thin string, from right to left or left to right, whatever it may be simply. Definitely at the junction point, these two must be obeyed. Just in order to make it simple, at x is equals to 0, the point is considered as a junction point. If you analyze these two, then by taking yi is equals to ai sin kx minus omega t, y reflected is equals to your sine of, sorry, this is first medium, so it is k1, let us take. Reflected one is also in the same medium, but moving in opposite sense, and that too thin to thick in the sense, at the reflection point you will get negative sign because of phase difference pi. And then transmitted one, that at into sine of second medium, that's why it is k2, and here in this case omega t, that too transmitted in the same sense, same direction of. So k value changes, that means medium changes, means one medium to another medium when it is transmitted. frequency remains constant, velocity changes, wavelength changes, and hence k value changes, and energy transmitted will be different from the incident energy. So now substituting these values in these two conditions, we can just arrive to a conclusion that ER and AT values in terms of ER and AT values in terms of K1, K2 values. Now, by taking these three, substituting them here, usually as we discussed, this is partial differentiation, but it is out of reach for us in intermediate level. So, I am just taking it as a differentiable elements here. So, by substituting these three in the first one and second one, and by solving it, you can get this ER value is equals to simply that K1 minus K2 upon K1 plus K2 times AI. Similarly, transmission value is equals to 2K1 by K1 plus K2 times AI it is. So, here just by considering this x is equal to 0 and these values, by doing substitution in the respective equations and by solving it, you will get it like this. And as we know, this k value, it is 2 pi by lambda 1, 2 pi by lambda 2. And by substituting, v is equals to omega by k, where omega is constant here. Substituting k is equals to omega by v here. This can also be written as v2 minus v1 by v1 plus v2 times of AI. This can be written as 2v2 by v1 plus v2 times of AI. So, this is AR is equal this much, AT is equal this much. So, AR by AI is called reflection coefficient. Like, of course, exact coefficient, if you take reflection coefficient, means it is the amount of, it is the ratio between the amount of energy that incidents to amount of energy reflected back to amount of energy incident. That ratio is what you call a reflection coefficient, exactly. So, similarly, AR by AI is to be taken, and the square of it is considered as exactly the reflection coefficient of that particular junction like. And similarly, AT by AI whole square is said to be transmission coefficient like. That is the square of this one you will get. That means, simply by writing it, we can take AR by AI is V2 minus V1 by V1 plus V2. Similarly, AT by AI is equals to 2VT by V1 plus V2. Absorption coefficient is the square of it, just like small ar. Square of it, if you take transmission coefficient, this becomes square. So, what they are exactly asking, depending on that, you need to consider that equation. So, usually it creates some confusion, well, all of a sudden just trying to remember. So, you better remember it properly so that you can answer it.